Hi there. You know, there are a few things out there more lame than internet drama, and that even happens sometimes on a Facebook group meant for cooking. I love our cast iron cooking group on Facebook, but even there, I've had to deal with a few troublemakers, and when they find themselves getting kicked off our group, they usually say to me, "You ain't got no balls." So, I'm making this video to prove that not only do I got the balls, but I can definitely say my balls are bigger than yours. You think you've got balls? Well, I doubt you have balls like these. Guess what? These are Rocky Mountain oysters. You know, that delicacy that cattle ranchers never tell you about. I came across these on a visit to a wonderful meat market in Pennsylvania, and I just couldn't get the idea of actually cooking these out of my mind. It took a while to order these because it turns out it's tough to get your hands on a pair of balls like these. And when I did some research on the best way to cook these, it seems as though the only way to make these is deep fried. But I saw a bunch of comments that suggested that when people eat these, most of the time, they're actually undercooked.
Chewy.
It does taste like chicken.
Yeah, I know. No, in here.
Tastes like chicken.
I'm down to seawater.
I'm not a big fan of deep frying, so I'm going to try something a little different. This is certainly a tough piece of meat, so I'm going to try my hand at braising these in wine in a manner similar to the preparations for boeuf bourguignon or coq au vin. So, with any luck, we'll have a pot of wine-braised balls, and I'll be having a dinner I won't soon forget. We start by freezing our balls for an hour to toughen them up and make them more firm. That way, they'll be easier to peel. Then, it's just a matter of taking a sharp knife and slicing away the outer skin to reveal the soft, juicy parts underneath. Now that our balls are exposed and naked, we have to brine them to remove the blood. This is done by taking a bowl of lukewarm water, mixing in 2 tablespoons of salt and 2 tablespoons of red wine vinegar, and soaking them for an hour. While they're soaking, we can prepare a mirepoix for cooking. The next step is to blanch our balls. We heat up a pot of water without reaching the boiling point and submerge our balls in the hot water for about 10 minutes. This will toughen them so they can be handled and sliced. Don't blanch your balls too long or they'll become rubbery, and nobody likes chewy balls in their mouth. And now, at last, we get down to the cooking. Bacon makes everything better, so first we heat up sliced bacon in order to render out the fat. We remove the bacon before it's crisp so we can add it later. And then we add our sliced balls to the bacon fat and sear the outsides. I noticed two things about this meat. First, the outside did not take on a darker color, even as it cooked. Also, these balls released so much liquid, I had to drain the pan. Once the liquid was let go, I borrowed a tip from Julia Child, added some brandy to the pan, and let it flambé. Flambéing your meat helps to make it more firm and less chewy, though even here the color didn't seem to change. So, we simply proceed and add our mirepoix vegetables. Some salt and fresh ground pepper. And stir it in the onions. To this, we add 2 bay leaves and about 1/2 teaspoon of thyme. We cover the pan for about 5 minutes to let it braise. When the pan was uncovered, I noticed the balls had finally stopped releasing more liquid, and the underside was finally beginning to caramelize. Now it was time to add the wine. We add enough wine to cover the food. Then add in the bacon, some minced garlic, and a tablespoon of tomato paste. Mix it all together. Then we cover the pan, turn the heat to medium-low, and let it simmer for 30 minutes. Half an hour later, I was surprised to see the wine had completely evaporated. I was expecting to see a thick sauce, but the dish was dry. However, it was wonderfully cooked. The underside had a thick coating, but it was not burned, and the balls had finally taken on a darker color. I had expected to add the mushrooms and cook this for another 15 minutes, but it certainly seemed as though this dish was done. So, I added a little more wine to put some liquid in the pan. I added the mushrooms now, and stirred it for about 5 minutes for them to cook. Then, it was ready to serve. And here we are, Rocky Mountain oysters, braised in wine. And of course, you would not be satisfied with this video if you didn't actually see me eating it to find out how well it tastes. So, here we go. Mm. You know what? This is delicious. Mm. You know how they always deep fry these things and everybody says that they're chewy or they taste like chicken? This is very, very tender. I think the wine must have helped to cook it thoroughly. And I'm going to have no problem at all finishing this. So, if you really want to try something different, if you really want to freak out your friends, and if you want an unusual, very unique, and excellent tasting dish, give this a try. Thank you very much for watching.